everyone, and welcome to part two of my 2018 favorites. I'm so glad you decided to watch this video. Now, if you haven't seen part one of this video, I will have it linked down below. So go ahead and watch that video. It honestly doesn't really matter what order you watch it in, but make sure that you check it out so that you get a full scope of all of the products that I loved this year. So let's get right into it. My favorite sponges of 2018 start with the Thrive Cosmetics. I believe it's called the Blend and Blur Sponge. This is $18, and yes, it is expensive. It is technically cheaper than the Beauty Blender, so I highly recommend it because this has the shape of the Beauty Blender on one side, but it also gives you that flat edge on this side, which you can see better like this, that you can get right underneath the eye for concealer, which is essential for me. Another 2018 favorite sponge is the Real Techniques Sponge, which you can see that it's loved because gross from me using it today. The Real Techniques sponge is usually about $5 or $6. Very affordable, very soft, great. This is a great makeup sponge, and I would highly recommend this if you are not wanting to spend as much money on a makeup sponge that works just as well. Highlighters, I have three favorite highlighters for 2018, and the first one is the Maybelline Master Chrome, and I would open it and swatch it for you, but it is actually destroyed. You can see how much I love this thing. This is in the color Molten Gold. I believe this was the first one I bought. I had the other two shades, but I gave them away because I thought it was ridiculous that I had so many highlighters. This highlighter is absolutely beautiful. This is a nice blinding highlight. You can pick this up for, I think, $10 at Walmart or Walgreens, any place like that that sells Maybelline products. They are definitely killing it with the products this year. I would say this is definitely a standout product. Another fantastic drugstore highlighter is the Wet n Wild Highlighting Powder, specifically in the shade Crown of My Canopy. I love this highlighter. This one, I think, is only about $5 or $6, even cheaper than the Maybelline one. I would say this is not as blinding as the Maybelline highlighter, so if you'd like something that's a little bit more subtle, go for this. Now, this is definitely not subtle, just a little bit more subtle than the Maybelline one, and I'll actually swatch this one for you. My last favorite highlight of 2018 is actually the Becca Cosmetics Shimmering Skin Perfector in Champagne Pop. I love this color. I will swatch this one for you as well. I actually got this in a little mini set that also came with a Becca primer. Just look at that. It's a beautiful blinding highlight. I believe the set that I got was only like $15, but I am totally okay with just having this little mini highlighter because I truly don't go through much highlighter. I use it every day, and yet, I don't know, I don't go through that much highlighter, but that's what it looks like in the pan. I have two mascara favorites from 2018. The first is the Liquid Lash Extensions by Thrive Cosmetics. It is exactly what it says it is. It is a tubing mascara. It gives you absolutely beautiful length, absolutely beautiful lashes. It is expensive, but I do believe it is worth every penny because for every product you purchase from Thrive Cosmetics, a product is donated to a woman in need, and I think that that is incredible. So knowing that your purchase is actually doing good, I think just makes it that much more worth it. I actually have a whole video talking about Thrive Cosmetics, and I will link that down below if you are interested in checking that out. My next 2018 mascara favorite is the Essence Lash Princess Mascara. This mascara is only about $4 or $5 at Ulta Beauty. It is a great mascara. It is great with volume, and it is great with just lengthening the lashes and just giving you that false lash look. I don't typically wear false lashes, so I rely on my mascara to make my lashes look great. So hence I will always be reaching for high quality mascaras, and these two have been the ones that I reached for more than any others this year. For brows, my 2018 favorite has been the LA Girl Shady Slim Brow Pencil. I've tried a lot of brow products, but this is my favorite. I think this is what I use most of the time, every day. This is so affordable. This brow pencil is, I believe, only $4 or $5 at Ulta. So even if you like to mix and match color to give more dimension to your brow, that's perfect because you'll only be spending $10 if you get two. My favorite eyeshadow palette of 2018 by far has to be the Soft Glam eyeshadow palette by Anastasia Beverly Hills. This is the perfect everyday palette. From day to night, you can create all kinds of looks with this palette. You can see it is very loved here. When I actually first saw the promo photos for this product, I was not impressed. I didn't actually think I would be picking it up. And then when I saw it in person, I realized that the colors were a lot more vibrant than I was perceiving from the photos. And I picked this up, and I've picked up too many eyeshadow palettes in 2018. But this is the one I reach for the most. You can see that I have just a hit pan on several colors, and I'm getting close to others. If you are into neutral shadows, if you are new to eyeshadow in general, I highly recommend getting this eyeshadow palette because it is so easy to work with, and I believe that the colors are flattering on pretty much everyone. My favorite lipstick of 2018 was the ColourPop Luxe lipstick, specifically in the shade Layover. I do also have the shade La Lady, I believe, but this beautiful, like, peachy nude color has been just an absolute favorite of mine. I will wear this with a deeper brown lip liner. It is just absolutely beautiful on the lips. It's so comfortable wearing, it's not heavy at all. And while I do like liquid lipsticks, most of the time I find myself wearing these because it's just a little bit more comfortable on the lips and I'm not worried about the way that they wear down. This one wears down beautifully. I highly recommend picking up these ColourPop Luxe lipsticks. They're only $7 at Ulta, at the Ultas that do carry the ColourPop cosmetics. My favorite lip gloss of all time and of 2018 is the Fenty Beauty lip gloss in Fenty Glow. I love this. Oh, I'm sorry. This is the Fenty Beauty Gloss Bomb in Fenty Glow. I love this thing. This color is perfect. The formula is not sticky. It's hydrating. It lasts pretty long for a lipstick and just it's so flattering on everybody. And I remember when this first came out, people were a little bit surprised that she only came out with one shade, but I think it's really cool that she came out with a shade that is universally flattering. And I definitely agree with that. I'm wearing it on my lips right now, actually on top of the ColourPop Luxe lipstick and Layover. And this lip gloss looks great on its own. It looks great on top of lipsticks. It looks great with high glam looks. It looks great with natural looks. I highly recommend picking this up. I actually picked this up in the mini set that came with a mini highlighter in the shade Hustler Baby, and I picked this up in the mini shades because I was too afraid to try, you know, just pay, I think, what is it, $18 for a lip gloss. But now that I've gotten this this mini lip gloss, I know I will definitely be repurchasing the full version when I run out. For setting sprays, I was finally introduced to the MAC Fix Plus spray. I know this is not technically a setting spray, but you can set your makeup with it if that makes sense. I actually love this, particularly when I have over powdered and I feel like it looks like there's a bunch of powder on my face. This is perfect for letting that powder really sink into the skin. I think that this works best when you spritz it and then fan so that it can dry pretty quickly. My only complaint about MAC Fix Plus is the sprayer. Sometimes it just sprays out globs and it's too expensive to be doing like two or three, you know, test sprays before I spray it out to remember exactly how it's going to be. And like, it makes me afraid to use it sometimes because sometimes the globs will mess up my makeup and I have to go in real quick with a sponge and fix it. You know what I'm saying? And I know I'm not the only person that feels this way, which brings me to my other 2018 favorite, which is the Urban Decay All Nighter Spray. This spray is fantastic. Truly, if you need your makeup to last all night, this is your girl. It does have a little bit of that like alcohol smell, so that makes me a little bit worried about its effect on the skin, But I'm still willing to use it because it just makes my makeup last so long. It's also great at refreshing the makeup in the middle of the day. If you, you know, have a long day of makeup, you can't fix it or anything, but you just need to spritz to make it kind of come alive again. Now, my problem with this, and I hate to, you know, be complaining, I feel like I go through this really quickly. I feel like I need to use a lot of it in order to feel like it's working, if that makes sense. Nevertheless, one of my favorites of 2018, I highly recommend picking this up. I definitely got this during one of Ulta's like 12 Days of Beauty sale type of thing. So look out for any of those sales because you never know when you could get lucky, pick something like this up for 50 or 40% off. And my last two 2018 favorites aren't makeup products, but they are beauty related. And the first are actually these microfiber towels. And they are super cheap. I highly recommend them to use to wipe off your brushes in between using them while you're doing your makeup. Like for example, if you use the same brush to do your foundation as you do to blend out your contour, you can use these microfiber towels to just wipe off the brush in between, you know, blending out your contour, which is, it's so nice. These are so convenient. They're also great just for cleaning your brushes. If you use a spray brush cleaner, if you want to spray your brush and then wipe these off, these actually help to get the color off better than a regular towel because it is microfiber. These are super cheap. You can usually pick up a pack of like two or four of these at the dollar store and even at Walmart for around that price as well. I highly recommend picking these up if you do your makeup a lot. And my last 2018 favorite is this Revlon One Step Hair Dryer and Styler. And it's basically a blow dryer that's also a brush. Now, I can't really speak for anybody that has straight or just wavy hair, but for people with natural hair like mine, I highly recommend this if you blow dry your hair. This will cut the time in half or in a quarter. And trust me, I'm not the only one. Look up other videos on YouTube. Other people have talked about how great this is. Of course, use heat protectant because this is still a blow dryer. It's a brush, but it is still a blow dryer. I highly recommend doing this. I think I blow dry my hair in less than 30 minutes at this point. And I don't blow dry my hair often, but I do like to blow dry my hair before I braid it down to wear underneath my wigs or a sew-in. So like I said, if you have natural hair, I highly recommend checking this out. I actually got this on sale when Ulta had it on sale for $20. So I thought, you know, might as well, $20. It's worth checking it out. And I am so glad I did. This is a purchase that I made towards the end of 2018. But I already know I'm taking this straight into 2019 and probably 2020 if it'll last me because this thing is fantastic. Thank you so much for tuning in to watch my 2018 beauty favorites. I appreciate it so much. And if you didn't get a chance to catch part one, I have linked it down below, so make sure you check that out. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Please hit the subscribe button if you haven't already, and also make sure to click the bell so that you don't miss any of my uploads. And I hope you're having a great day or night wherever you're at. And please, please, please leave some comments down if you have tried any of these products, how you feel about them, or if you want to try any of these products. All right. Thanks again for watching. Bye.